would you guys do before you die? Like, if you could do one thing?
If one thing? What if we have many things we want to do?
I don't say, I'm not done yet.
Okay, what are some of the things that you
want to
do?
There's this, like, infinity money and time. Well, not really time, but infinity money. Like, do we have the option to, do we have, no matter what, we can get it done? Or is it just like, give me the scope.
I think it should be within reason. I mean, nothing would be impossible, but you're probably still going to have to put a little effort towards doing what you want to do.
Nothing's impossible when you follow your dreams, man.
That's right.
Let's just get that going right now.
That's right.
And isn't every movie Christmas if you believe it or something? What you going to say?
And you can take that thought, put it in my hand, and I'll close it up and hold it next to my heart.
You can wish in one hand shit, the other see which one feels more real.
Depends on if I got the diarrhea.
The diarrhea.
Sometimes that'll run through your fingers just like dreams.
Nah. How do you know that?
You don't want to see the bathroom.
It was a desperate time in my life.
He ran out of toilet paper. That's what happened.
He was dreaming in one hand, and he's like, well, now I got to poo.
I look over. There's no toilet paper, and I hear, where's your God now?
Well, there's a shower curtain, so.
And so I did.
I don't know if what I would want to do. I think if I had the ability to, I would go see a black hole before I die.
Hell yeah.
Sweet.
Just to see what the event horizon would look like, and the accretion disk, and just all the good stuff that comes with the spaghettification that would happen to me.
You know the shitty thing about
spaghetti?
That?
Spaghettification.
He is a pasta licker.
Hey.
Hey.
You know what the shitty thing about that is? What? You'd never be able to tell anybody about what you saw.
Of course. That would be terrible. But if there was a way I could broadcast it at all.
Put this up on YouTube, guys. Live space.
Hey, guys. It's your boy Dan here. Just like and subscribe below. But check this out. I'm in a black hole? Question mark? That's not annoying or anything.
Dan's in a black hole?
So you're like a bunch of the other YouTubers out there.
Yeah.
And hey, you guys. Can list stuff hey, like guys. They do, too. Like, I got up today, and I got dressed, and I went in the black hole.
Oh, we're gonna go over some YouTube stuff here in just a minute.
It's not just YouTube, though. I call it soccer mom everywhere. Talk.
Soccer mom talk.
I went and got a coffee. I did my yoga, and I was like, I gotta get something to eat.
Everything they say is like a question, like I got in my van today? Like, do you not know?
I always try to do that to him, but I end up asking a question.
Do you not do it wrong? Do you not think I believe you or can follow the conversation?
Did you see your socks? Damn it.
That's what I did. I'm like, should we go get, dang it, I screwed it up again.
We'll talk about that in a minute. What would you do, Dance?
What would you do?
There's a lot of things that I think I would do.
Living all alone because I'm bad anymore because he's hungry. Oh. And the only way to feed him is to sleep with a man for a little bit of money.
God, shut up.
City high. Anyway.
Well, that's it.
It's going to sound pretty dumb to you.
Why would it sound dumb to me?
I want to play a crowded arena.
You want? That's not dumb. That's a cool thing. I've never got on stage, so that'd be something I'd want to do.
I play some pretty decent shows, man, but I want to play a crowded arena.
Just like a thank you.
That's good night. To see you guys, not like you
open. Yeah,
you want to headline your own tour, right?
I wouldn't care if I was an opening act, really. I just want to, like, just wow everybody.
Yeah, that'd be sweet.
Like, it's Vans and the Roses.
Why would I think that'd be dumb?
Because you think everything I think is dumb.
Yeah, but well, not all the time. No, not all the time. But I can see why you might think that. I think it would be dumb, but no, I don't. I think it's a pretty good ambition to have. In fact, I mean, you've got the means to do it. Just get up on stage. I've never been on stage. I don't know what that's like. I don't think I have the gumption to get on stage.
It's good stuff.
Doing a podcast is a lot different than getting up on stage in front of people telling jokes. It's the one thing that all my friends...
Yeah, we try to get you to do a comedy show, and you wouldn't do it.
Yeah, everybody wants me to get up on stage, but they don't know how nerve-wracking it is if I bomb. And everyone's like, well, everyone bombs. Are you going to start somewhere? It's just like, yeah, but I'd take that as a serious blow to my confidence.
What you have to remember, though, is it's not like you're going to be in the grocery store one day and someone's going to be like, hey, aren't you the guy that bombed on stage? Like, no one's going to remember you if you bomb. But if you're great, people are going to be like, oh my God, it's Dan Wanda. Dan Wanda's over here.
Why do they sound like that?
Because you're...
He's famous in New York comedian now.
Yeah, to play a stage in New York would be pretty damn sweet.
Yeah.
I don't know if I could ever get there, though. I don't know. Maybe one of these nights I'll do Funny Bone. I don't know.
I'd like to narrow mine down to Red Rocks.
Oh, hell yeah.
Red Rocks?
Yes. Yeah. It's beautiful there.
Oh, like Colorado?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Natalie?
I have two. Well, I have a list of many, but I'm going to yell two. Definitely would go to space. And I would also like to save at least one endangered species from going extinct before I die.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Thanks. No, I really would.
My band could play a benefit show.
Yeah, bro. That would work.
For your species.
And Dan can be the stand-up comedian. Done. We have a whole gig.
You guys heard about these species? Nah.
I just flew in from Nebraska, and boy, are my arms tired.
Boo! Get off the stage! You suck!
I never heard that joke before. What?
Boo! Hiss. Do people hiss anymore for heckling? Is that a thing?
Hiss? I know, but I'll make sure to have some cabbage and tomatoes and such, like, rotten for you to have thrown at you.
I'll just make a salad.
Why you gotta throw all this cabbage at me? I'm hungry.
Don't threaten me with a good time.
Look, all you gotta do is scrape the mold off.
Lick off that salmonella.
We would ask Nick, but there's no Nick today.
Aww.
He had prior engagements that he's doing, so...
No, he's not engaged. Ladies, he's still single and ready to mingle, but he had...
Yeah.
He's on strike until Ryan Gosling calls him.
Yeah. He's gonna call.
He came up with that so quick.
He did?
Yes.
He had that fucker in the chamber.
Ryan Gosling. It's almost like he was sitting here like, God, I hope they ask me about a same-sex celebrity crush.
Cha-ching!
He's been saying that since, like, day one of recording. 30-some episodes later, they finally asked.
Afterwards, he gets up. He's like, well, I'm all done here.
See, the cool thing about your guys' stuff is that you can almost do it. Like me, I'll never go see a black hole.
You might be able to.
No, I think the nearest one, it would take me, like, oh, I broke my phone. It would take me about, like, 90 years to get there.
The 1990s.
I don't think you know what you're talking about.
I do. I was in black hole once.
But you can get up on stage, Vance, whenever you feel like it and have something to put up there. But
well, it's not like I can just climb up there.
Hey guys, I got this.
Move for over, Slipknot. I'm way too fat.
Yeah, but
losing weight,
that's your other goal, right?
No, there. I mean, I'm not too fat to play music. I'm literally too fat to climb up the front of a stage. I would have to be invited and walk up the stairs. Like, I'm not just going to crash the party because, well, I'm too fat.
What would Nick's be?
This is a fun game. Let's see.
I think Nick would choose to...
One milkshake, two straws with Ryan Gosling.
You want to know what I think Nick would do?
What?
I think he'd want to spend a day as a cat.
Yay!
He does love cats.
I think he'd want that.
We both do.
We're talking about him like he's dead. Like, I think he'd really like that.
He'd like that.
He really wanted to climb up my lap and coil up.
Or he'd want to hang out with, like, Wes Craven, and they could talk about Scream all day.
And then how boring it is. Ooh.
Oh,
he can't defend himself because he's not here.
Do you guys remember the time when he said he liked Scream and we all shunned him?
That was fun.
Remember the time he broke my cup?
He shattered that fucker.
That was so cool, though.
It was weird.
The bottom of it just knocked out. I think we talked about this last episode.
Did we?
Yeah.
Are we sure?
Yeah.
I don't remember.
He seems like a nice guy.
Let's do a flashback.
Yeah, there's no Nick today.
That's okay.
I don't think there's Nick again next week either.
Why don't we go ahead and tell the people who the rest of us that are present are?
So this is the Don't Look Under the Bed podcast, and we want to... Just right off the bat, thank you for listening.
A lot.
And
thanks.
I'm one of your ambitious hosts.
Ooh.
Dan Wonder. Next to me is
Natalie Rose.
Next to her is
Vinny Rose.
And I am the Dan Wonder that is sitting next to no one because he's not. That's that thing threw that whole thing threw me off. Like, it's, since he's not here, it goes back to me, I guess.
Fire.
I'd like you guys to know that when Dan does look over here at me, he's looking at me lovingly.
That's where you're wrong.
Across the table.
But going back to...
Hey, you told me you love me.
YouTube videos. So, we're on YouTube. And I've been looking at popular videos on YouTube and seeing what goes on out there, what's trending. And a lot of it is, like, politics, right? Ugh. And then you have... It's not always like that. It can be. You can have good conversations in politics. You just got to choose the right people. So anyone who agrees, really, but no. but what's trending on YouTube? Is, have you ever seen those things called mukbangs? Mukbangs?
No.
Mukbang.
No.
They're basically like there was. I think it was made by. It started getting popular with Asian people, but it was about you take a bunch of food. Like a big meal, and you eat it in front of somebody, and then you talk about it while you're doing it, or talk about random stuff.
Is it to make the other people hungry, like you did with your Raising Cane's with Natalie today?
I think first and foremost, shout out to Raising Cane's because that's amazing.
First and foremost, yum.
I'd like to have a chicken finger off with Raising Cane's.
A finger off.
Yeah. I don't like that.
Well, I almost said strip off, but
were you in the room when B Wonder was talking about Raising Cane's?
Nope.
Okay, they put one in. He lives in Cincinnati, or the Natty, as he calls it,
which is really just too bad.
He said they put in a Raising Cane's, and they had to have cops and everyone there like directing traffic because it was so busy.
No shit.
Yeah, he said it was. Insane. So I'm like, well, while you're here, just eat at one of our like five locations. I mean, yeah, you might have a little line, but nothing like that. So I think we'll take him to Raising.
That's crazy.
Yeah. He was talking. Oh, you weren't here. He was Vince made him breakfast.
Oh, really?
Biscuits and gravy.
Oh, I want some.
It was really good.
You're at work.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wanted some too, but I just had to sit there and eat stupid Jello
and hash browns and sausage patties.
Oh, so you made Brandon the perfect breakfast. We'll get to that in just a minute.
Hey, you've eaten some pretty good shit here too.
I have. The ham and potato soup is really good. But
stop talking about food.
Yeah, there's channels that trend like that where it's you're basically having dinner and a conversation with somebody who's just talking at you.
While they eat,
and you can, I don't know, you can eat. I eat while watching stuff. I don't like eating without watching something.
I don't want somebody to talk to me while they're eating, like.
Isn't that sad?
Fast?
You know, I think one of the most...
No, they're eating the whole thing. Like they're... Look at... When you get a chance to look them up, you can look them up. You can
see... Okay, what'd you call me? Mung beans? What'd you call them?
Mukbang.
Hey, I was close.
Grungy mung holes.
No, that's not it.
You know, one of the most interesting things that I think I've seen in a long time is the day that you and I were watching the video on the guy that was eating all the...
MREs.
MREs, yeah.
Steve 1989 MRE Info channel.
Yeah.
I talked about that in my book club that I'm at, because we read a book about... And it had some like apocalyptic stuff in there. I was like, my brother watches this YouTube guy and he eats like old MREs. So I think he got a few more listeners that were a few more viewers that day because they were all checking him out.
He deserves it, man. He's not annoying. He uses proper grammar and diction. Like he is a... He's a good dude, and he eats really almost botulized food. So who knows? Or
does he scream into the microphone?
No,
I cannot stand that. Oh,
that's for kids. That's what kids like, because they like having people that are loud next to them.
Animated,
yeah, or animated. Which I mean, when I was a kid, I liked that shit too. But
no, his son, and then like our nephews. Oh my god, when they play that YouTube shit, all those people do scream in the microphone, and it like. I don't know, what do you call it when it goes over?
It goes in the red?
Yeah. I'm like,
it over-modulates.
Yeah. Clips. Like, oh, I can't handle it.
The decibels are too high.
It's called clipping.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. But look at what trends on YouTube these days. I mean, it's
all screamers.
It's basically all screamers for 12-year-olds.
I've been on the YouTube once or twice, tell you what.
But look at all the dumb shit we liked when we were kids.
Yeah.
I mean, I liked Flom. Speaking of, do you guys remember the 90s? A whole lot. Like, yeah. Do you remember how the 90s was the era for, like, for awesome. Kids? It was the era for kids. Like, it was, everything was gross, and everything was like creepy.
I think a lot of that had to do with Nickelodeon.
Nickelodeon was the shit in the 90s.
Yeah. I remember on Friday, Saturday Night Snick, as Saturday Night Nick.
Yeah.
I always watched they told the scary stories around the campfire.
Are You Afraid of the Dark?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I used to wait all week for that to come on.
We had Double Dare. You can't do that on television. Salute Your Shorts.
Also, like,
TGIF. I don't know, those 80s or 90s. Yeah, oh, yeah.
Who didn't like that shit?
Hell, yeah.
You get off school, your mom's making mashed potatoes and beef
cutlets. Full House Friday Nights for me.
Yeah.
Still is. Full House
Friday Nights.
Still is.
Didn't go out and get friends or have meet boys. Nope, it was TGI Friday.
I did a lot of fun stuff around that. I had no boys. So, like, just me and my friends, we were always out doing stuff, like...
Riding bikes.
Yeah.
A lot of times we were doing dumb shit like
Adam's Adventures.
We cut the legs off one half of a picnic table and made a ramp out of it.
That sounds fun.
It wasn't. Okay. It was not not nearly as awesome as it sounds because the ground hurts. But just always doing cool shit though.
No, I remember Gak, Flom. They had, like, the creepy crawlers, so you can bake them in the oven and eat them.
Hell yeah.
Oh, man. That was the whole era, though. It was nothing but, like, Salute Your Shorts, Welcome Freshman, Nick Arcade.
Rocko's Modern Life.
Rocko's Modern Life, and Nickelodeon was awesome. And then something happened.
I'm old enough to where, like, I even remember a lot of the cool shit from the 80s, you know?
I remember some cool stuff from the 80s, too.
Garbage Pail Kids. They were so
cool. And it wasn't Terrible Trolls. Brandon corrected me. It's Trash Can Trolls.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thanks, B.
So he called me stupid right away from that
one. He's not wrong.
No, yeah, no. Okay.
He is actually going to be our special guest on our show for next recording.
Mm-hmm. I have Perfect B on,
finally. All the way from Cincinnati.
Oh, Brandon calls it Landfill, Ohio. But we love you listeners in Ohio.
Yeah, thank you.
I live there, so...
I'm going to go there. Vinny and I are...
Like, I don't understand...
We're going on a little vacation there.
I don't understand CB. Why they eat Skyline chili. It doesn't...
I didn't like it.
I tried
it. He bought some.
And I like chili.
Yes, but he does.
Well, once Brand's on, we'll talk about that.
Yeah, he'll be on he lives next there. Recording.
They put chili on their spaghetti.
They put cocoa in their chili.
Yes,
it doesn't make any fucking sense.
Cinnamon or cocoa?
Cinnamon.
Yeah.
Who cares?
Well, we'll wait because he'll be on the. We'll be recording with him soon, so you guys can all get a taste for the bee.
Ooh,
especially the ladies.
Not like that.
Especially the ladies.
All right, I'm done. Come on, Tenebrae, let's go upstairs.
They'll be sitting by me.
Tenebrae's Nick today. He's doing a much better job.
He's so quiet.
He is.
We do have an email, but before we get into that, Natalie, what is our,
Vance read the email.
Did he?
Yeah, that's what was, I'm sorry, he didn't read it, like, formally, but that was the, what would you?
No.
No.
Oh.
That wasn't it.
All right, girl. I'm sorry.
Now, before we get into that, though, what is our show about tonight?
Oh, tonight we're going to read, some stories of people that have had, like, real, quote-unquote, real hauntings or creepy occurrences in their lives. Just and, you know, these are all on the internet, so they're all true. So I just pulled off a bunch of different websites and just, you know, kind of lighten the mood a bit.
Okay.
Fun. Well, okay. Maybe not lighten the mood. Some of these are pretty good. Like, ooh.
You'd be stupid. Ooh. Marty. All right, Vance.
Cocaine's and banana peels.
You got the email pulled up?
I do.
I thought you did read the email. I'm sorry.
Look, y'all, we got an email.
Thank you, Cleveland.
You're welcome.
You got to do it. You got to do the whole thing in this voice now.
Those are so his mannerisms. Okay, so.
Don't look at him because he'll laugh.
Okay, I won't look at him.
You're in a horror movie. And your partner in fear is the most famous person with whom you share your birthday. Who is it? And are y'all going to survive? That's Jen. Thank you,
Jen. You sound like my old supervisor from the Hobby Lobby.
Oh.
I could just see him talking.
I can't get Cleveland Jr. off the couch.
Off the couch.
First, I thought it was the epilepsy. Then I just went to see what was on the TV. Oh, that's nasty. No.
So we looked some of these up. We cheated a little bit. We had to look up who shared our birthdays.
Yeah, because I had no idea.
Vance, why don't you start?
All right. So there's a lot of famous people. Charlie Chaplin is one of mine. Akon. But I think my favorite is going to be either Bobby Vinton or Martin Lawrence. And I think I'm gonna go with Martin Lawrence.
And you're gonna survive? It'd be like a horror comedy.
Yeah.
Are you gonna survive though?
Bad Boys 4, y'all.
Oh man, I can't wait
for Sorry, Will.
Uncle Phil. Natalie, who'd you have?
I had a bunch. A lot of mine were was it Ted Bundy that was on mine, but I'm not gonna Ted use Bundy it. Was I think on it was Ted Bundy.
Quick question. If I use Martin Lawrence, can I have him as Shanane?
Yes.
Oh my god.
Oh my goodness.
There's no other way to do that movie.
Oh my god.
Oh my goodness.
Oh man, my
Why y'all tripping?
Shanane.
Mine, Stephen Merchant.
Yes.
Yep. For those of you who don't know, he was the writer, creator, writer on The Office.
Yeah, one of them.
Yeah, one of them, not like the only one. And then the other one I had was Colin Hanks. So I'd be okay with that, with either of those two. I'd probably take, Ted Bundy was on my birthday too, but he's not common with us.
I'd take him just because he knows how to kill people.
Yeah, but so does Colin Hanks, if you remember from Dexter.
That's true,
but yeah. Stephen Merchant can write us some really good plot lines to maybe get out of some stuff, so I'm going to take in Stephen Merchant. And I survived, but I used him as a sacrifice.
Oh, you push him in front of the...
He's my shield.
I had Selena, too, but I think we all know how that would end up.
Selena, like the...
The singer?
Yeah.
Really?
Yep.
Wow.
President of her fan club shot her. Mm-hmm. Or the treasure or some shit.
That's right. We did an episode about that, didn't we?
No.
We did celebrity deaths. She was like a
celebrity death, but yeah.
Oh, okay.
Not like a Selena.
Also, episode. I have Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, who trained under Bruce Lee, so I changed my mind. I'm going to go with Kareem.
You guys got fun ones? I had Huey Lewis from Huey Lewis and the News and Pauly D from Jersey Shore.
What if you'd have just got the news?
Who's Huey? I don't know. No, but it was his birthday, and... I don't know if I go with any of them. I'd probably use Pauly D as a human shield.
Yeah, I'd say Pauly D would be a great.
Just push him right into the fucking buzzsaw.
He's putting on tanning lotion, and you're like putting him in the buzzsaw or in the grinder.
You probably annoy the fucking guy to death.
Bro, what are you doing, bro?
Yeah.
GTL.
Gym tan laundry. That's how I do. I never watched one episode of that.
I don't think I've
seen it. But I know that.
I did sit down to watch an episode because I'm like, I have to see what all the hype is about, and then I turned it off.
Because I'm a this smart person.
This is fucking terrible.
Because I'm a what smart person. What in
the hell is going on here? And they were like working at, I'm sure this is like back in the day. Sorry. Bless you. They were working at a t-shirt shop, like making t-shirts on the pier or something. I'm like, this is entertainment? Question mark?
TV from the past, I don't know how many years, has just gone down. I don't even watch TV anymore. I just... I got Hulu, and...
I like...
there's still some good shit.
Yeah, see, there's good stuff. Like, we watch, like, the comedies and stuff, like Modern Family.
Shout out to the Goldbergs. I really love that show.
Yeah, you and Brandon.
But he likes it, too? Oh, my God.
Yeah, he'll you guys can talk about him the next time that he gets on the show.
Yeah, he says a little kid reminds him of him.
Adam. A little kid?
Adam. Like, all this 80s stuff that he likes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, TV has just gone downhill, and reality TV is probably the bane of our existence, but whatever. Some people watch it, I guess.
Because you watch, like, Hell's Kitchen and
stuff. That's not reality TV. That's a game show.
I love anything to do with Chef Gordon Ramsay.
I like him. I think he's a phenomenal dude.
He's an artist.
And he's he specializes in his craft. Like, there's not too many other cooks out there that have what he does. Now, some of the shows are a little, they use the same cymbal sound 30 times in a row.
You know what? I should have went with that, because I always tell Natalie, I'm like, I'd like to just cook with him one time. Just me and him throwing down in the kitchen.
People, let me tell you about my business.
You want to cook with him?
Yeah. Maybe that should be one of the things. I actually really like to cook.
Maybe that should be one of the things really you do before you die.
Cooking.
Instead of getting on stage, try to just pay Gordon Ramsay to come and give you a master class. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I honestly wouldn't know what to do if he tried to teach me. I'd be like, I'm not a good cook at all.
So I put the cereal in the bowl?
Yeah, it just starts on fire.
Or do I dump the milk in the box? I burned it.
It's fucking raw!
I burned it. I'm sorry. Sorry.
What are you doing, you donkey?
And, you know, I think one of my favorite things about him, though, is he makes stuff that's so good, but, like, if he does one of his little video tutorials on, like, to make the perfect burger, he breaks it down to where you could do it. If you watch his video and do what he does step by step, you can make that good food.
And you can do it, too.
You can do it, too.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not a good cook, so I don't take leadership like that.
And he's got fucking phenomenal hair.
He does.
He does have gray hair.
That's
that tousled look.
That tousled blonde look.
But actually, it probably takes a few minutes to do.
It's fucking raw! Where's the lamb sauce? All right.
Mm-hmm.
Natalie?
Yes?
Go for it.
All right. So, like I said, I just picked these off the interwebs. So they're all true. Every single one of these. I'm just going to read some random ones. And I'll put the links on the description for the show so you guys can, you know, read some on your own too. So this first one here, I was staying in a Flamingo Hotel in Las Vegas, oldest property on the strip, with a sordid mob story. In the middle of the night, I woke up and saw a dark figure moving around the foot of my bed and coming up the gap between the twin beds. I hit the light, and there was a full figure man in a 60s sports blazer with blood all over his face. I yelled, "Go away!" And I started to fling my arms in his direction. Just like that, he disappeared.
Go away!
Shoo! I woke my friends in the other bed, and my buddy said, "What the hell are you swatting at?" I told him, and they laughed at me.
It's the cartoon birds around me.
Go away!
I'm going to swing my arms like this, and if you get hit, it's your fault. The following morning, my buddy said, after I had fallen asleep, water was dripping on his bed. Water.
Water.
But there was no leak in the ceiling, and I was convinced we may have shared a paranormal encounter. Or somebody got drunk and peed the bed.
Yeah.
Vinny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bro.
Yeah.
Bro.
Oh, no.
Dude. No, I didn't mean that, Vinny.
Did you pee the bed?
No, dude, I was ripping waves.
No, but you could have been ripping waves in your pants.
Oh, you are surfing the gnar.
No, now, be honest.
Shredding the gnar.
Okay, did you pee the bed,
though? I did not.
I got a straight face that one.
I did not. I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
I did not pee the bed.
There's this guy I work with. He can do Bill Clinton's voice so perfect, dude. It's great.
So perfect.
So perfect. I can't even do it.
It's my objective to make sure.
I like how you hold your hand up, like the presidents always do.
Americans. They put that thumb out there.
They always do that. Like they're hitting the buzzer on Jeopardy.
Yeah.
Speaking of Jeopardy.
Oh, yeah. Is it true?
Happy thoughts and good vibes going out to Alex Trebek.
Why? What's going on?
Stage 4 pancreatic cancer.
Mother.
Yeah, dude.
Hopefully that's just like an internet.
No, it's real. Yes, okay. It is real.
I was hoping it was just like and one of those things.
It really hit me when I was reading it, and one of the things that he said was, "I just wish that I would have met my wife sooner so I could have spent more time with her."
Ooh, that's a scorcher.
Ton of bricks.
Yeah.
Because Vance doesn't think that way about me. Just kidding.
Meet her later.
I wish I'd have met you like yesterday.
That sucks.
Yeah,
it does.
So what's that mean for him now?
Stage 4 pancreatic.
Well, I was reading that and I was like, I'll take tug at my heartstrings for $500.
Aw.
It was sad, dude.
I know, but you just made a joke about it.
I didn't mean to.
Tug at my heartstrings.
It wasn't a bad joke. Like, I wasn't meaning any disrespect.
It's a Daily Double.
Shut up.
Daily Double, these tears?
Is this a video? All
right, Allie.
What happened to Mark Summers?
He does production now, I think.
And he did have that really good food on, or that Food Network show.
I always forget what it's called.
It was really good though, because he showed you how stuff got like food.
Nick,
got
look made. That up for us.
Nick.
He's at home.
what was that called? He's looking it up.
It wasn't Good Eats. That's Alton Brown.
Yeah.
Who's one of my favorites.
Yeah, I like Alton Brown. He's so smart.
Smart.
God, he's smart. Unwrapped.
Check out Unwrapped.
Yeah. That was a good show. All right. Anyways, let's see. Move on to the next one. One night, my mom heard a crash noise in our kitchen, but I figured it... I was up and dropped something.
My dad was drunk.
Dad dropped his bong.
Oh, man.
The next morning, my dad walked down the stairs and thought there was ice on the kitchen floor. But he said, looking at it, the ice wasn't melting.
It was yellow.
It was glass shards. They cleaned up the glass.
It was meth. That's what that was.
Breakage, bitch.
They cleaned up the glass, which was on the floor, countertops, and even under the lip of the countertops, along some of the top of the drawers and cabinets. It was as if someone stood back and threw a glass object at the wall or something. We had no idea what it was from. The glass was too thick to be anything of a vase or glasses, or even some bowls in the house. We had a huge family meeting in the kitchen trying to figure out what happened and where the glass came from. We still have no idea.
It could have been something in the middle of the night getting in the house.
I am calling bullshit.
It's like that bat on Black Sheep.
Yeah.
Just comes in.
What the hell is that?
Oh my God.
It's Ozzy Osbourne.
Yeah, I found white mud.
Yeah, and I'm going to be rich because I'm the only person in the world who can find white mud. I didn't say mud, I said crud.
Yeah.
Why don't you come over and watch
I had him watching Almost Heroes the other day, but he fell asleep. But his son liked it, and his oldest son liked it, and he
Where
was
are
laughing.
You, damn bird.
Hey, you know what?
It was the shells.
I want to be fair here. We just got a new couch, and you can't not go to sleep when you're on that couch.
Really?
Oh.
Yeah. Even though
it's
bad.
Like there's a gas leak there.
I know where that's coming from.
Not like a Daniel gas leak.
No, come on, that was supposed to be turned around in advance. That's not fair.
No, because I sit there and fall asleep too. And I don't go shit in my pants. Or am I? Tell you what.
Till you quit.
What? All right. A few years ago, my parents went through a very difficult separation. Mommy? Daddy? We moved into a smaller house, and by the end of the first day, my youngest brother, who was about 5 years old, seemed to change completely.
Never mind. Nope.
No, go for it.
Nope. This is a family show.
He's not my sister.
I wasn't going to say that.
This is the 90s. It's okay.
It's ma'am. He went from being a rambunctious troublemaker to a very quiet child. At first, we thought that was great because the kid drove us crazy. Even after 2 weeks after the move, we began to feel a little concerned that he wouldn't go into the kitchen or backyard alone. One day... What?
Mom, there's something wrong with Billy. I haven't wanted to beat the shit out of him in like a week.
Me either, honey. Eat your peas. One day, some friends came over and we spent the whole afternoon playing in the yard. My brother was having so much fun that he didn't even realize it was getting dark. Suddenly, he went white as a sheet and started to cry, saying that there was a scary boy with a messed up face on the roof calling out to him.
Why is he up there?
Hey! I'm up here!
He's in the fireplace. Why? That's such a weird spot.
I'm cold. 2 days later, a neighbor told us that shortly before we moved in, the couple who had lived there went out one night and left their 6-year-old locked inside. The kid had tried to make something to eat, but ended up setting fire to the kitchen. Oh, shitty.
What?
He burned his ramen noodles. The neighbors managed to put out the fire, but the child apparently died right there in the yard.
Shit.
That sucks. When my mom got back to the house, she started to frantically scrape the kitchen wall, and lo and behold, under the white paint was a burned wall. We moved out a few days later.
Really?
I don't think you moved out a few days later.
No, I don't
think that was Natasha Mertens from BuzzFeed.
Plus, you're not going to scrape paint off to reveal a burned wall.
Right.
You're not just going to paint over a burned wall. They're going to replace the fucking sheetrock.
Yeah, don't you got to do that and then replace some of the drywall, too?
Sheetrock is drywall stupid.
Oh.
Ding, ding.
Ow. My pride.
It's funny because it's true.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I used to be a constructioneer.
Yeah.
I got my pink tool belt. And I got my little screwdriver.
What the hell's wrong with this guy?
And my poundy thingy.
I'm just doing...
You're not even hitting anything.
I hate socket wrenches. Get me a ratchet.
Oh, I hate you.
Oh,
I didn't know sheetrock. I didn't know sheetrock.
We're going to get rid of all these two befores. We're going to replace them with studs.
Dale, sorry, do you have a stud? Ooh, I'll get some.
Those are my favorite.
This one's Victor. This one's Thomas.
Hey, what's up?
What's up?
I used to know Kenneth, but he just let his triceps go to hell.
Can't have him in the lawn no more.
Just put new exhaust on my car. Oh, I thought it was a muffler.
All right, we can stop now. I didn't know one thing.
I'm sorry you're dumb.
All right, one day I was over at a neighbor's house to lend her some things for a Halloween party. I hope she got invited to it as well. A
couple sugar and a thumbtack. That's all she needed.
Apples in a bucket.
One of her friends, who I'd never met before, started talking about spirits. A while later, he turned to me and said, "Wow, I'm feeling a really bad energy behind you." Someone... Someone who has a name that starts with an I. I froze and said, "That's my grandmother's name." And had been...
Eunice.
Arasi? Araki? I-R-A-C-I? Arasi?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sounds like an old bird's name. And that she died about a year before. I had a dream of often kneeling on the floor and begging for my forgiveness. This friend told me that she was always close to me. She wasn't going anywhere until I did something about it.
And I'm gullible enough to believe it. Because a cold read is a cold read.
Did you watch... Do you like John Oliver?
Yeah, I watched Last Week Tonight. They did a
Spiders. That was so good.
Yeah, because he fucking trashed
yeah,
him.
Yeah,
I couldn't stop laughing.
Come oh my God. Spiders.
She's doing stairs. She's doing stairs, hon. She's covered in spiders.
She's trying to reach out to you, but she can't.
She can't reach out. It's see the spiders. They muffle her screams.
Who's shout out to that guy. Who was that guy?
Lenny.
Yes, he is hilarious.
I'm sensing a negative energy out of her butt.
I can't hold his pinky up while he's doing it.
Yeah.
He's pointing.
Can someone please understand?
He's not doing it for real, guys. He's doing it like a comedy skit. It's hilarious.
Yeah, if you're going to look up anything tonight, look up two things, and I'll show those to you at the end of the episode. So you got to keep watching.
Because you know everybody would just duck out right now. Something interesting? Fuck.
We just lost 10 listeners. Damn it. We can't keep them here.
All right. I had a black cat called Casper. Oh, that's original.
That's dumb.
Yeah, stupid. I mean, I'll take your cat from you because you named it something dumb.
That's abuse to Natalie.
It is. So stupid. God, I don't even want to read this anymore.
Hey, Casper, fuck you. That's what that cat's thinking. Yeah. Fuck you.
We adopted her after she ran away from her previous owner.
Adapted.
Well... That's okay then, I guess. He adopted her. She was missing for days before her previous owner found her in the bushes, skittish and frightened. After carrying her home, the owner discovered that she was allergic to cats when her arm broke out with rashes. She put a call out for a new home, which was answered by my animal-loving family. For ages, she was scared to come near anyone and was totally adverse to being petted. Eventually, she turned into a total ham, never missing a chance to jump up and lie with you. I have a few of those. We loved her and I loved her heaps. That's weird.
Here's one of her heaps right here. I love it.
She's so heapy. Then one day she lost the use of her back legs. Not long after she passed away. Oh, this is a sad story.
Tenebrae thinks it's sad.
I know, as I'm petting Tenebrae and he's screaming. I was having a rough time then and she was a big comforter. Point is, my parents and I were sad. A few days later, I'm sitting on my front step having a smoke. Well, I hope it's not a marijuana cigarette. And I hear meowing sound identical to Casper. I look out front, and there at the gate was a cat meowing at me that looked just like Casper. I went over and it ran away. I looked down the street after it and it was gone. I mentioned it to my parents and they both said the same thing had happened to each other separately, which was no surprise to them. Now, it could have been a similar cat for neighborhood, but it only happened once to each of us and it was never seen again.
Okay. It's like the people that name their fucking Great Danes Tiny.
Ugh, yeah.
Stop it.
Goldfish Goldie.
Stupid.
You're still stuck on that.
Little poodle and you call it fucking Brutus or Spike. So, yeah, it's killer.
I can't believe you're still stuck on this.
It pisses me off. Sorry.
It pisses me off then. Gosh dang it.
Can you understand, please?
Covered in spiders?
First off, feral cats exist. So.
Yeah, we have one.
We have two of them.
Yeah, so having a cat come to your street and not want to be around you is a normal thing. I don't think anything happened to your cat. I'm sorry that you lost it, but
our feral cat we named Hocus. That's a good name.
Yeah.
That is a good name. Okay.
What's all right. Next one? This one's called I Lived with a Ghost.
No, you didn't. No, you fucking did.
I mean, not exclusively. We're kind of on again, off again. You know?
You know, it's just easier for the rent. It's cool.
No.
Alright, I live with a ghost. I rented a furnished house for a hell of a great price. And
hell
afterward,
of a deal.
Is that spelled hell of a, like, or hell UVA? Hell of a.
H-E-L-L-U-V-A.
Oh, fuck you. Fuck. Don't read this one.
Nope, we're going to continue because you hate it. So afterward, I started to hear some sinister noises in the attic, like footsteps or heavy, something heavy being dragged. I called the exterminator and he said everything was okay.
A-okay.
A-okay.
And then but shit up there anyway. All right.
I got some asbestos and some rat poop.
That'll be $500.
Yeah, no shit. After a little while, I started to realize that the cabinets in my kitchen couldn't simply stay closed.
That's a magnet problem. That's not a ghost.
God, look at it.
It's a ghostly cat named Casper. Oh!
Every time that I got home, more and more drawers and doors were left open. Then one day, when I got home from work, all of the doors on my wardrobe in my bedroom were open. I called a pastor friend, calm down, Daniel, of my grandmother to pray over the house. It didn't work. The ghost started to turn the lights on and off as well the TV while I was watching it.
Oh my God.
I did some research on the history of the house and discovered that a young lady had once died there, but I still didn't know how the death came about. I've been living there for a year and 7 months. For now, I'm just putting up with my supernatural roommate, particularly since they've never done anything to cause me harm, except for making a big mess. Amanda Fidalgo.
So, here's my question. If no one had told her about somebody being dead in their house before, it would have just been a fucking coincidence, just like everything else. But somebody put that crap in her mind, and so now she thinks there's a fucking ghost that lived with her. And then that just boggles my mind how someone can go from a magnet problem that can be easily solved. Your drawers being opened up and stuff like that. And unless somebody's breaking in and sniffing your panties or something like that, that's a little different. But
I keep my panty drawer locked.
I was about to say, you might have to.
Locks and keys on Vance's panties.
I call it my wardrobe.
Oh, man. All right, next one now.
I want to move out now.
There's no. Vance's ass is haunted.
Yeah, Vance's ass. No, that's the haunted ass in the room.
Yeah.
No. This one's called My Little Cousin Said That He Waved Goodbye and Flew Up Towards the Ceiling.
Oh my gosh.
These are so much fun. We're going to have to do these again because
Dan. See you later!
Yeah. You stopped busy lifting drinks. Now he touched the ceiling, which has to be decontaminated. You lose. You get nothing. Good day, sir.
And he won because he gave him back the everlasting gobstabber.
You won! I like his hat.
Did you see the Saturday Night Live skit of when Charlie goes home and he has the chocolate bar, like, you know, he does in the movie, and he finds out that he wins a ticket. But it's about the two grandparents that are in the bed.
Yeah. You guys just sleep here?
Oh, my God. And then the two start, like, making out and going at it. Oh, God, that was so funny. Ugh. I couldn't sleep with somebody like that. Ugh.
All that feet in the bed.
Oh, God.
I'm still very upset.
Funk. The funk.
I'm still very upset that they named their black cat Casper.
Dude, so you gotta stupid. Let it go.
I got an iguana named Iggy as well.
Wow, you guys are
worse than me. I've never, yeah. I will bash that all day.
Welcome to another exciting episode of Dan Hates Everything.
We got a roast tarantula named Rosie.
Can't stand it when people make shit up. And you know this stuff is made up.
This is on the internet, so it's real.
Anyway, now...
Okay. My grandfather died when I was 9 years old. He was always crazy about the grandkids, and we still see him appear randomly. Every time he appears, some bullshit's about to go down. That's exactly what it is.
Is it really?
Yeah. In fact, once...
Fucking grandpa's here again.
In fact, once he appeared to me, the next day, I got run over.
Wait, hold on. He appeared, and then the person was run over? Or
the next day. Not so, the grandpa.
Oh, okay, so...
The grandpa appeared to the person.
And then the person got ran over.
The next day. He said he... They geared his... Actually, it's a girl. This
grandpa
lady,
wasn't dead. He was hiding in the car waiting for you to go out in the street.
I'm crazy about these kids. Real crazy.
Come chew grandma's toenail.
I just shat my pen.
Did you say come chew grandma's toenails?
No, gross. Now who's... No, come on.
Sometimes it was cute, though. When my cousin was 3, she was getting out of the bath when suddenly she started to laugh and hold out her hands. My aunt asked her what happened, and she said, Grandpa's pretending to hug me and blow kisses. Don't you... Stop it, both of you. Stop.
Did she have a C cup shape when she had a...
Stop it.
Grandpa's blow...
Oh my god. I didn't really vet
these. Not the only thing that's getting blown around here.
Yeah, did not vet these stories. My aunt, who was used to dealing with these random appearances from her dead father, asked where he was. My little cousin said that...
I used to have to hold his balls while he was alive.
Who wants to hold Grandpa's balls?
Grandpa, they're clear down by your knees.
You get your hard candy. Let me put that in your mouth. Hold on.
It's not even wrapped. You just pulled it out of your pocket, unwrapped.
He rubs the wrapper over his dry ass tongue.
Tastes like paint. Tastes like wood.
I'll make us some sandwiches. Okay.
My little cousin said that he waved goodbye and flew towards the ceiling. Lucio da Rosa Perrier.
Wait, what the fuck? Okay, so back up. Back the truth trolley up here.
Okay. Ding, 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 ding,
the
ding,
guy,
ding.
The grandpa's dead.
10-4.
And he loved his kids a lot.
Grandkids.
Okay.
Too much.
What is him getting run over with the fucking...
He said every time he disappears, some bullshit's about to go down.
That doesn't make any sense.
Well, it's on the internet and it's true, so we have to go with it.
So,
like, I don't care how close you are with somebody. Don't visit a naked 3-year-old. It's not all right.
No, it's not. Bath time fun for everyone.
That's my step pepper.
You know, 20 years later, guys are going to be like, it's okay, pretend I'm your grandpa.
Gross.
All right.
Okay.
What are you doing? I was just saying, like, I'll give you, like, a hug and some hard candy. Why is your hands like that?
I got you a Werther's Original.
Grandpa. Here.
Until the Jews took it over. They get all mad.
I love Werther's Original.
They're gross.
No.
No, they're really good.
I am like an old so man when it comes to hard candies. Like, I will have a pocket full of Werther's and be happy all day.
When her and I were remodeling this basement, before our thing was... Eyes. We'd go get a box of Bit of Honeys and just eat them while we were...
And others. We would just eat them while we were painting and stuff.
You're just old people. That's all you are.
Yeah, but they haven't met Menards.
I love old people.
Of course they have Menards. Old people shop there.
You shut up.
You save big money. They're not our sponsor yet. Hopefully soon one day.
But and we saved 11%.
We spent
big
a lot
money
of money there.
Menards.
For our craft and projects, we have to spend a lot of money there. All right.
You said Nards.
All season's greetings to you all from Nards. It's great.
That was very nice. That was very nice.
I think you're going to be the guy to do the commercials. After all these years, we're changing it. After we heard the Don't Look Under the Bed podcast.
Season's greetings. Anyway.
All right. We were building an addition on the back of the house. Ooh, rich people. And there was a fight with our neighbor because she was using our trash bin without asking permission.
Grandpa went over to their bathroom.
And you flew got into the ceiling.
I'm the trash man.
Flew into the ceiling again.
When we went to complain, she said that whoever was going to live in the addition would be haunted just because we messed with her. She put a curse on them.
So wait, she
spell on you.
She used their trash can.
And got pissed when they called her out on it. So that's about right.
This is the dumbest story.
No, the Casper one was dumb. we laughed about it, and the construction continued. But every damn day, my dogs would be barking at the place uncontrollably. It got to the point where my dad went out, found a folk healer. Only after that, the dogs stopped being afraid of the addition. And a Caroline Mora.
He mispronounced throwing my money away.
Yeah.
I wish people would just give me their money instead of throwing it away.
I know.
Just give me your money. I can do way more cool things with it.
Yeah.
We can go to Cece's Pizza.
Cece's Pizza
is great.
F-word's disgusting.
F-word's disgusting.
I like it.
Well, they're not even around anymore here because they're so
nasty. If you wanted to send us to Cece's Pizza,
go to Patreon.
Yeah.
Just go ahead and go to... For these fat bastards to eat pizza.
There is no Cece's anymore.
I know.
Have we ever talked about Cece's?
Nope.
Ugh.
Quick story.
Hurl.
We took my kids and your niece and nephew to Cece's when they were really little. And we had a good time, played the claw machine after we ate and everything. And we're walking out, and your nephew, he walks outside, and there's this car sitting right parked up like to the sidewalk. He just walks up, doubles up his fist, boom, right on the car's hood, looks at Natalie and says, "I didn't get my afternoon pill." There's a dude in the car. He swells up like he's pissed, man. He goes to open the door, and I just pointed at the car and shook my head no. He's like,
tuckered back down and
I didn't get my afternoon pill.
Yeah.
I'm going to start doing that from now on. Every time I'm mad at work, I just go up
to Trey like,
and punch him. I ain't got my afternoon pill. They're like, "Oh, okay, here, we'll feed you one."
No.
Come to Grandpa's. You get all the pills you want.
I'll see you in the bathtub. Ooh. When you won't be lonely.
Stay away from the blue ones. Those are mine.
Those make you happy. Natalie doesn't like it.
I'll read a couple more and then we'll wrap this bitch. But we'll do some more of these because these are pretty funny.
That was a real gangster of you.
Thanks. My mother used to say that she always saw a random little girl in the house, but it hadn't
happened. It was her.
Oh, it's my reflection. But it hadn't happened in a while. Recently, my girlfriend was at our house and we overheard my brother playing with a little girl in the living room, but there was actually no one with him. When my mom told me about it, she got all covered in goosebumps and had a fit. We had to call her three times before she regained consciousness. Could it have been that same little girl?
Absolutely not.
I think the best part is you reading these off like you actually give a shit.
We didn't know. Do you ever read the Dear Abby? I sometimes read like that too. We don't know because my mom came back to herself. But so that she couldn't remember a thing. Heloise Malaris.
Your mom's senile. The little girl was your brother. He just acts like a little girl sometimes. Moving on.
Okay. When I was 10 years old, I slept with my sister in the room.
I didn't say anything, Natalie. That was all him. Grandpa likes little sisters too.
Come get your lemon drops. When I was 10 years old, I slept with my sister.
You'll be happy for the rest of your life.
Sleep with a sister. Okay.
I slept with my sister in a room with a curtain for a door. Sounds like a makeshift room.
No, this person's a sponsor from India. We're going to start sending this person.
Oh, yeah, I guess it could have been.
With a curtain for a door and a door for a floor.
For 30 cents a day. You can help the sisters.
But I'm going to take half that 30 cents and only give them like a penny once I'm done.
A whole penny.
Because when you're done, they'll be adorable.
One night, I woke up looked toward the curtain and saw a silhouette of a tall, long-haired person. At the time, I thought it was my mom. But when I looked away, I came face-to-face with a long-haired figure slouched on the edge of my bed looking at me. I instantly shook all over, got really scared, and managed to close my eyes. But I wasn't sleepy at all. As soon as I closed my eyes, I passed out. I don't remember anything else from that night.
Guess that it was tireder than I thought.
You were drugged.
Yeah, no shit.
It goes to Bill Cosby. It's
Bill Cosby in a wig. Moving on.
It's your grandpa. Nothing else like that has happened since. But that figure intrigues me to this day. Camilla Ribeiro.
You're a liar.
Dirty liar.
Like, we're just calling them
out. You fucking lied on
BuzzFeed. What if they show up here to beat us up?
That wouldn't happen. That wouldn't happen.
Too tough. If you wrote in to him and you were reading your story,
I'll scissor kick his gizzard.
All right, we'll do a couple more. I'll wrap up here. We'll do this again, though, for sure. My grandmother told me a story about the time when my youngest aunt was 16 years old, and the family was so desperate to move out of their home. The reason? A ghost wouldn't let this aunt of mine sleep, eat, or anything at all. She lost weight quickly. Oh, must be fucking rough.
I heard this one. It was Reba McEntire saying, like, here's your little chance, here's fancy. Here's your chance,
fancy. And the roach cries, I call my feet. She lost weight quickly. What? The song Fancy by Rhea McIntyre. The
fuck are you talking about?
It's about a little girl getting turned into a whore by her poverty-stricken mother.
To get her out of the house. She wanted her to go marry money.
Just be nice to the gentleman, Fancy, and they'll be nice to you.
Here's your one chance, Fancy, don't let me down.
Wow, that's pretty dark.
Forgive me for
what I do. It really is. It really is.
But she said, forgive me for what I do. That's a good song.
Forgive me for what I do, woo-woo. Is that how it goes?
Nope.
Okay. I just mixed wait till I get my Hanes on you and then just put that in there. And that's
she lost weight quickly and spent all night arguing with herself and telling the young man, go away, because she wasn't going to marry him. Nobody believed her until one day when my uncle decided to see if this ghost for himself. He pretended to be asleep in a... all right, calm down, you guys. He pretended to be asleep in a bed beside her and ran out screaming because he saw the young man, too.
Such bullshit.
Riza Inacio?
Whatever.
Teresa.
You're a liar. No, you're a goddamn filthy liar.
All right, last one here. In a house where I used to live, there was a little boy ghost who I sometimes saw. Excuse me. The first time is when I had some friends over. It was just the three of us until I saw a reflection of a boy wearing... Oops. Until I saw the reflection of a boy wearing old-fashioned clothes. I was floored and told my friends. Suddenly, a pot in the kitchen counter was hurled through the air, and it scared the crap out of us. The other time was when I was in my room listening to the radio. What do you think she was listening to?
Probably Britney Spears. I don't know.
Yeah, we'll go with
it. Britney Spears records.
I had left the door open and saw this boy looking at me from the doorway. When I went to see him, he took off a running. I thought it was my...
running?
Yeah. Oh, I put the in there.
Running down a dream.
I thought it was my brothers, but they were in the living room watching the TV. What were they watching?
What? Disney Channel.
Yes. When was this?
I didn't say. Years later, I found out that my cousin saw him, too. She described him perfectly to me, even though I'd never told anyone about it before.
They're so dumb. They were watching Public Access, I guarantee it.
I love Public Access. There's a bunch of cool shit on there. Especially our senator when he's... one guy. Was a commissioner, what is his name?
Hashtag create.
Forgot the guy's name.
I love the Create channel.
I don't know the channel.
It's like a local, like... PBS type channel.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so that was it for those. Like I said, we'll do these again. Pretty fun.
A lot of bullshit.
Were all true because they're on the internet.
No, they're not.
Yes.
We have endorsements for the week, don't we?
Brandon said that we're stupid for endorsing inanimate objects that can't say thank you.
Okay, I'm endorsing the Osmonds. There's a song called Crazy Horses by the Osmonds that sounds way better than the Osmonds ever put out. And
yeah, definitely not like anything that you would think the Osmonds.
And it's fucking amazing, and you need to go YouTube it right now or on your
right after you're done listening to us, though.
Yeah. No, not now.
At least wait till we plug you for money.
Yeah. but go check them out. It's called Crazy Horses by the Osmonds, and it's really fucking good.
It's trippy.
It's really good. And yeah. I wish that band would have stayed that way. God, they would have. They probably wouldn't have had as many fans, obviously.
They would have paved the road quite differently for that era.
1972 is when this song came out.
It did not sound like a song from 1972.
No, it sounded like a song from like 1975.
78.
76, maybe. But they were pretty ahead of their time with this song.
I would have said 80s.
Down.
No, it's really Black Sabbath-y.
Oh. I don't know what they sing, so
I don't like Black Sabbath.
I don't either, but that song's really Black Sabbath-y.
All right. What are your guys' endorsements? And yeah, you can have endorsements. It's our show.
You don't Brandon have... said stop it.
No, I'm not doing that.
My endorsement is food in general, because I get to eat again starting next week.
That's good.
No more.
What's your favorite kind of Jell-O, Natalie?
Oh my god, I fucking hate. I'm so sick of Jell-O. I'm sick of protein shakes. I'm sick of Jell-O. Tummy work.
Yeah, I ate the rest of the raisin canes over there.
Why'd you fuck off?
What's your endorsement, Vance?
The Goldbergs.
All right.
I really have had a lot of fun with that. It's good, clean fun, too.
Good, clean fun.
Good, clean
fun.
Not
the dirty kind.
I love that show.
My endorsement is Tenebrae, because he's a precious angel bear sleeping.
Hey, Vance.
Yes, Dan.
How can people get a hold of us?
Well, Dan, the best way to get a hold of us is... I guess call. Fuck, I don't know. No,
What'd you forget?
I was about to say, what the hell?
They can email us at don'tlookunderthebedpodcast@gmail.com. They can go to our website at don'tlookunderthebed.net, click on any one of the links there, or... Fuck, they can call us. No, I'll put Dan's phone number up on the website.
Hot single ladies.
No, we're on Facebook. Don't Look Under the Bed Podcast. You can search Twitter at DLUTB. I believe our Instagram page is DLUTB as well. If you like what you're doing, you want to see us do more of it. I mean, because we definitely want to start doing some traveling and maybe some ghost hunting, or at least some off-site interviewing people and stuff like that. Anything would be appreciated. We're at Patreon/DLUTB. We also accept at PayPal, and that is just our email address. don'tlookunderthebedpodcast@gmail.com. But if you can't do any of that, we're more than happy just to have you listen.
Yep.
Because we appreciate it, and it's fun. We're on, what, episode 33, 34?
Yep, 34.
And it's still just as fun as episode 1 to sit here and do these.
Yeah, I agree.
And especially when we look at today, and there's been, you know, probably almost a double in listeners over the past 2 weeks.
Yeah, we spent, which is great.
That's making me really happy. Mm-hmm. All of us happy. We cannot tell you how much we appreciate the listeners and the emails that you guys are sending in. They're so funny. And if we didn't get to yours, hang on, man. We're gonna try. We get a lot, so you know, we grab the ones that we think are people are gonna be interested in, and maybe that's what we could do sometime, is just pick some random emails. And
just go through, just have an email
that
show.
That would be fun.
Yeah, we could do that.
I'm down for that.
I don't
that.
See why not.
We'll number emails 1 through 20, and then we'll roll a D&D die.
Yeah. Yeah, that'd be cool.
Who says those here?
I'm going to start making a D&D post-apocalyptic game, so
I like it. Fun. I like it because I could use a lot of mechanical knowledge to help with that.
Hey, how can they watch us stream games coming soon?
You know, we are... So we did have a stream up, and it was just DLUTV at Twitch, but I don't know what happened with that. It's just not usable for some reason. So I am in the process of making a new one that there will be a link to our Twitch channel on the website here in the next couple of weeks. And hopefully that Twitch and maybe even Mixer, I don't know, it's all going to be up and running, and... We'd like to get some good content on there for you guys.
Yeah, I'm gonna start streaming once we get it set up.
I'm not good enough to stream anything.
Sure you are.
But I'm a girl.
So, he's just saying that because he's your husband.
I don't blame him. I've played Nintendo.
One. I really don't do that unless I'm like, yeah, your brother's all right.
All right, well, thanks again for everybody listening, and we hope you have a great day. Once again, this is the Don't Look Under the Bed podcast.
Dude,
podcast
we love
for
you.
All things comedy and horror. I'm one of your ambitious hosts, Dan Wonder. Next is
Natalie. Grandpa loves you, Rose.
Next to her is
hiding under the table, Vinny Rose.
Hiding under
for
the
waiting
bed.
For Grandpa.
And Nicholas Myers will be back in another episode. No, the
couple episodes
from now. So
he's got a life or something.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck that's like.
It's ridiculous.
No, I'm ridiculous.
Ridiculous.
John, get my nose back. All right, so 30 Rock, check it out
for sure. Thank you guys all again for listening.
Thank you.
All right,
bye. Oh God, I think Dan fought it.
No, come on.